CataractCoach.com, intumescent cataract needle decompression with our guest surgeon, Lukan Mishev from Sofia, Bulgaria. Now, the idea here is to get the fluid out of that intumescent cataract before starting the capsulorhexis. So placing a 27-gauge needle on a 3cc syringe, we can puncture the anterior lens capsule, being careful not to go too deep, and then we actively aspirate on the plunger, and that helps remove the fluid from the capsular bag and deturgesses it. As a result, now that there's no pressure in the capsular bag, we can complete the capsulorhexis without any issue. We've shown previous videos here on Cataract Coach of other techniques for dealing with these white cataracts and creating a capsulorhexis without having that risk of Argentinian flag sign, or at least minimizing it. So you can see that's a beautiful capsulorhexis. And now time for the little chop technique. This is always fun to watch. Dr. Mishev is a fantastic surgeon. He's designed his own chopper here, and you can see easily splits the nucleus down the middle, rotates it with the same instrument, and chops again. And of course, multiple chops later, we're gonna just remove all these pieces. Fun to watch. You can also see the curvature of that chopper, which facilitates this specific technique. And that instrument is available for purchase, and it's named after Dr. Mishev. So again, nucleus is split into many pieces, and all we do now is simply remove the pieces. Now, all cataract surgeons are going to end up dealing with an intumescent white cataract in their training, as well as many times throughout their career. So it's imperative that we learn to deal with this here. Other techniques we've shown in the past are using the phaco probe to puncture the anterior lens capsule, using other devices, maybe even a femtosecond laser, but that's certainly very expensive, or even just using a small cystotome to do a double rexus technique, a baby rexus, and then completing the larger rexus. I also want to remind you, check out cataractcoach.com. It's our teaching website. You can submit your video. Also sign up for a free daily email. I love my YouTube videos, but there's a lot more material on Cataract Coach. Now we're going to show you the same technique of a needle decompression done by a resident surgeon, a surgeon in training with about 100 cataracts of experience. So needle going in, notice that it's beveled down, puncturing the lens capsule, and then actively aspirating, pulling fluid from within the capsular bag. And then the nucleus can be rocked a little bit, and we can inject that here on the cornea, and you'll see a lot of the intumescent fluid that comes out. So this is the fluid that was aspirated from the capsular bag. Let's wash that off, and then the resident here is going to complete a capsulorhexis. Now that the capsular bag has been decompressed, the risk of an Argentine flag sign is very low. So now it's okay to start the main incision, which we'll make here, and then we'll use the forceps to create the capsulorhexis. So it's a nice tunnel length, good looking incision, and this surgeon's left-handed and will be using the capsulorhexis forceps in the left hand. So forceps go inside the eye. Now there is still some risk of the Argentinian flag sign, but it's quite low, and you can see the anterior lens capsule has been flattened. It's not dome-shaped, it's completely flat or even slightly sunken in the middle, and that'll make it a lot easier and give you a lot more control in the capsulorhexis creation. So you can see here, there's no urgency in rushing through this. There's no pressure. If you leave things for a moment, you don't get that automatic extension of the rexus edge. Again, that's because the capsular bag has been decompressed. The danger in the Argentinian flag sign is when the pressure within the capsular bag is higher than the pressure in the anterior chamber. When you start to create a capsulorhexis in that scenario, almost certainly the rexus edge will run out and you're going to run into some trouble. So here the resident's doing a beautiful job of creating a round capsulorhexis. Very nice, beautifully centered, appropriate size. And this case is going to go great. So definitely keep all these techniques in mind. I want to thank Dr. Mishev for a beautiful technique. After we saw his video, we noticed that we had a white cataract on our schedule, and so we had this resident do the exact same technique. And if this resident with 100 cataracts of experience can do it, I'm certain that you, all the viewers out there, can certainly do it as well. And there's the completion, and that's a beautiful round rexus. Thanks for watching.